Welcome to Females and Fine Fettle, from Wiped Out to Wealthy. This is where conscientious women entrepreneurs and women living like a boss come to learn about balancing their personal and professional wellness with ease. If you have the enthusiasm, motivation, and grit to make it happen, then listen up every Monday. To be sure you don't miss an episode, sign up for weekly updates at femalesandfinefettle.com. The following discussion is for educational purposes only and is not intended to diagnose or treat any disease. Please don't apply any of this information without first speaking with your doctor. Now, here are your hosts, Ashlie Rose and Dr. Michelle, functional medicine doctor, naturopathic physician, and East Asian medical practitioner.
Welcome to our podcast. I am super stoked that you decided to join us. This first installation will just be a little get-to-know-you session so you can learn more about us and why we decided to do this podcast. So to get started, I'm Dr. Michelle, a functional medicine practitioner, naturopathic physician, licensed acupuncturist, and certified Chinese herbalist based out of the Pacific Northwest. I run my private practice out of Vancouver, Washington, but I'm able to provide virtual consulting, which is super convenient for those of you ladies who don't live in the area. In general, I specialize in a root cause resolution approach to holistic hormone balance and autoimmunity. So what that means is that instead of focusing on finding the right pill for the ill, whether that be a pharmaceutical or a nutraceutical, I work with you from a body systems-based approach to find the core imbalance. That way, we can remove the obstacles to cure and restore the body's natural ability to heal from the inside out. Along with being a physician, I'm also a writer, speaker, online course instructor, and health advocate. And I am super excited about this podcast because it's not only a way for me to empower and motivate more people, but it's a platform where I can let loose a little, where I can sort of speak my mind and share my perspective while still providing some serious skills for you to live more vibrantly. So basically, don't be alarmed if I throw in a few expletives now and again, because I can get really passionate and excited about these topics. So when I'm not out there health caring, I'm usually at home on the farm. My partner and I live on about 10 acres outside of the city, so during our off hours, we're usually gardening, battling blackberries, or experimenting with some new skills to fuel my homesteading aspirations. I think that's a pretty good start for me, so now I'd like to introduce you to Ashlie Rose, my co-host and dearest friend.
Hello, everyone. Yes, it's true. Misha and I have been besties for 15 years. Currently, I am pursuing my bachelor's in biology. I am a lifelong learner. I've worked in a range of industries and find that my passion in all avenues is connecting with people, which is why this platform is perfect for me. Something that Michelle has said to me for years as a friend, and I'm sure she tells her patients, is that life is all about balance. So in relation to our friendship, we bring differences to the table that often make a balanced whole. So I, like many of you, perhaps, am on a perpetual and often interrupted health journey. I like to try new things, but sometimes I step back, I lose track. It can be really overwhelming with all the information out there. So I, too, am here to learn more and let my health focus fit more seamlessly into my life and make it a priority. But my goal for this podcast is to act as a bridge to you, our audience, responding to your emails, your comments, reviews, making sure that we're covering topics that you want to hear about. So Misha and I are best buds, and we want to be ourselves with you, which often means talking really excitedly or talking fast. But rest assured, we will always post show notes on our website so you won't miss a reference or any information. Podcasting is a format that we love. We are avid podcast listeners and supporters. We truly love this community that continues to grow around it, including you. Okay, so to start, I'd like to do a quick Q&A face-off with you, Dr. Michelle, so our listeners can get a better idea of the kind of gals we are as we navigate our lives in order to maintain our inventive focus and keep in fine fettle. So, numero uno, what is your morning routine, or what is your favorite morning routine?
To be honest, my morning routines are a fairly new concept for me since I've only been a semi-early riser for the last couple years or so. I was the typical night owl and cherished my morning sleep-ins for as long as I can remember, but something shifted a couple years ago, and I noticed that as my health improved, I actually started to enjoy waking up earlier and utilizing my mornings a bit more effectively. Now they're some of the most productive hours of my day. So what am I doing or striving to do now? Being on the farm, I don't typically have to set an alarm because Chuck, our resident rooster, keeps us on a schedule. But if I do end up sleeping through his morning announcement, then our puppies will usually get us up no later than about 7. I will admit, I do have aspirations of having a regular wake-up time around 6 or even earlier, but as with most things, it's a process. So once I'm up and before my feet hit the ground, I try to finish off my water bottle from the night before. I always have a water bottle with me, including by my bedside. So hydrating first thing is essential. It helps get my digestive tract moving and helps flush the toxins that were processed overnight. This is definitely a non-negotiable for me. A new addition to my morning routine has been this meditation I was recently introduced to. I've been doing it at least every other day or so, and I feel like I'm actually at the point where my body is craving it, as weird as that sounds. The particular one I'm doing right now is called Blessing the Energy Centers by Dr. Joe Dispenza, and it's from his book that I also happen to be listening to right now called Breaking the Habit of Being Yourself. I've tried various meditative practices in the past, but this one is really resonating with me. It really helps set the tone for the day, and it keeps me motivated towards my goals. After meditating, I usually brew up some yerba mate, and if it's a work day for me, this tends to be butter mate, which really helps get me into the flow for the day. You may have heard of bulletproof coffee or butter coffee. If so, this is my non-coffee alternative. As much as I love the taste and the smell and the ritual of coffee, it just doesn't really agree with my body, so yerba mate is my go-to morning beverage. And then if I'm feeling really motivated, I will do a kettlebell workout, which once I get started, I totally love. It's a great full-body, high-intensity interval type routine that I do. Oh, and one other thing, I pack up my lunch. Sometimes my awesome partner does it for me, but either way, it gets done. It might sound a little silly to some, but meal prep is a serious key to success. It keeps me from hitting up local restaurants and getting something that might not fuel me in the way that I want for the rest of my day. So that's what I've got going so far. It's always a work in progress. So how about you, Ashlie? What's your morning routine like?
Yeah, so as I mentioned before, my health path is constantly evolving. So that includes my morning routine. It's sometimes inconsistent, but, you know, I'm human. So while I am intrigued by the 5 a.m. miracle mentality, I'm not quite ready to get up that early. But I do get up on my best days at 6 o'clock, and I'm currently dabbling in Abhasanas, which is this ebook created by Morgan of the Southern Yogi on Instagram. She's an acro yogi, and it's about 50-something pages of strength poses. I would periodically go to yoga classes, but I more often than not just stay home and watch videos on YouTube like Yoga with Adrian. It just depends on my mood, because I would get really discouraged when I would go to a yoga class and I couldn't remember all the moves, and so I was always looking around at the class. It took me out of the moment, and I feel like yoga is such a personal practice that I don't necessarily want to be around a lot of people, honestly, but that feeling comes and goes. So anyway, I love Abhasanas because I'm able to learn more from home in a place that I feel comfortable and gain confidence with these power moves so that I can create a flow that actually is specifically tailored to me. So I just love it.
Okie doke. So second question, do you have any self-care practices to help you recharge? And if so, what is your non-negotiable?
Getting outside is huge. For me, stress tends to build up slowly over time, so it's really important for me to schedule in some time in nature. Luckily, I live on 10 acres, like I said, which is amazing, but sometimes I really need to get out. So backpacking is really high on that list. A patient of mine recently told me about this place called Tunnel Falls out in the Columbia Gorge, so I'm really anxious to check that out. Also, I have to include Epsom salt baths. I try to take one probably once a week. They're super relaxing and an awesome excuse to listen to some music, an audiobook, or a podcast. What about you, Ashlie? How do you relieve stress?
I'm sure I'm not alone. Sometimes I put on a good song, dance my ass off, or I'll sing at the top of my lungs, probably in my car. Even more, like, if I'm agitated about something, whatever it is, honestly, these days, for a long time, I just search for a podcast episode among the many that I'm subscribed to, something with the content that's relevant to my current experience or my current stress and that's aimed at combating it. I find it's incredibly effective, but it also reminds me to just find my center in some way and quiet the noise. It really puts things into perspective. So last one for now, top three blogs or podcasts that you can't imagine your day without and why.
Such a good one. I listen to podcasts daily, hence the inspiration to start our own. My top three are Bulletproof Radio. Dave Asprey always has awesome health topics that range from simple lifestyle modifications to really pushing the limits of our health potentials. I'm also addicted to Online Marketing Made Easy with Amy Porterfield. Pretty much all the social media and online course know-how I've learned has come directly from listening to her. She is a powerhouse of information, and her podcasts are filled with super valuable content. Lastly, I adore the Evolution of Medicine podcast with James Maskell. It's largely dedicated to practitioners in the functional medicine community, and for me, it really helps keep up the momentum, the motivation, and the inspiration, because practicing medicine outside of the conventional box can be really challenging sometimes. I love their community. I love the dedication and the passion involved in shifting the paradigm. So how about you, Ashlie? What are your top three favorite blogs or podcasts? I have a sneaking suspicion you have more than three.
Okay, so I feel like my life was forever changed by NPR's This American Life with host Ira Glass. I've laughed, I've cried, I've often been washing the dishes while doing so, and it just makes me feel really bonded to humankind. A second podcast that I love is NPR's TED Radio Hour, hosted by Guy Raz. It offers a compilation of TED Talks based on specific themes. It's really easy to navigate in terms of the content you're searching for, and they do a great job of batching talks throughout TED's time. My third favorite, in no order whatsoever, is Stuff You Should Know with hosts Chuck Bryan and Josh Clark. I will talk about this show to anyone who will listen. It's excellent. Their rapport keeps me coming back. They're just really funny guys. And I am going to sneak into more podcasts that I love. The fourth would be Where Should We Begin with famed psychotherapist Esther Perel. In each episode, she discloses a particular couple's therapy session with their consent, of course, and it's just really fascinating listening to and dissecting their problem, even more so that we're dissecting somebody else's problem rather than our own sometimes. And then The Moth Podcast, which re-airs stories from The Moth Radio Hour. That's just an amazing show with live storytelling, and it's just so fascinating to listen to.
Awesome. Yeah, Esther Perel is great. All right, so I hope that gave you a better idea of who we are, or even better, we hope you found some likeness or even some inspiration. If you want to check out any of the resources, books, or podcasts that we mentioned, we've got them listed in the show notes at femalesinfettle.com. Our guess is that if you're listening to this podcast, you're a busy lady like us, so our episodes aren't meant to take up your whole day or even your whole commute.
Yeah, we want to keep it brief and keep it actionable, so our aim here is to feed you some seriously good content in only about 15 minutes or so. And each month, we'll also be doing exclusive interviews with other lady bosses from across the globe who will offer their expertise and their tips and insights gained along this unpredictable path of entrepreneurship. We'll also be offering a freebie in every upcoming episode, so don't miss out. Be sure to visit femalesinfinefettle.com and click on episode 0 to receive your freebie. This week, we have Dr. Michelle's 6-week email series entitled Get Answers, Be Empowered, Live Vibrantly.
It's a streamlined guide where she covers topics to help you reach your fullest potential. Things like improving nutrition, healing digestion, reducing stress, balancing hormones, optimizing immune function, reducing toxin exposure, decreasing inflammation, and creating healthy habits for a vibrant life. Be sure to check it out.
Hey, yeah, it's Dr. Michelle here, and I cannot wait to meet you back here next week. In episode one, we'll be talking about how important creativity is to your health and four of my favorite ways to easily incorporate it into your daily routine. Thanks for tuning in. Have a great rest of your week. Bye for now.
Thank you for listening to Females and Fine Fettle from Wiped Out to Wealthy, a podcast to fit your lifestyle. If you like what you've heard, please subscribe, rate, and review at femalesandfinefettle.com. If you have questions or topic ideas for upcoming episodes, we'd love to hear from you. Please be sure to tune in next week.